Now let's study the magnetic force on a closed loop in uniform magnetic field. Here you can see there is a uniform magnetic field of induction D vector in which a closed loop ABCD carrying a current I is placed. And it is placed in such a way that its length L is perpendicular to magnetic induction and breadth B is parallel to the direction of magnetic induction. Here in this situation, if we calculate the force on different segments of this loop, here we can see force on section AB. If we just see AB section, the current is flowing parallel to magnetic induction. So here we can see the force on it is zero. And if we calculate the force on section BC, here you can see in the section BC, magnetic induction is toward right and current is in downward direction. If I use my right hand palm rule, here we can see I am pointing fingers in the direction of magnetic induction and thumb in downward direction. So my palm face will point in outward direction. So we can write its magnetic force is BIL in outward direction. And now we can see force on wire segment CD will again be zero because the wire section is parallel to magnetic induction. So IL cross B will be zero. And we calculate the magnetic force on wire section DA. Here you can see magnetic induction is toward right and current is in upward direction. So if I use my right hand palm rule, fingers pointing toward magnetic induction, thumb along the direction of current, and my palm face is pointing in inward direction. So it will be the same force BIL in inward direction. So here we can see the net force on loop, the total magnetic force on loop here is equals to zero. So we can write whenever a closed current carrying loop is placed in a magnetic field, uniform magnetic field, net force acting on the closed loop will always be equal to zero. And this inference you can also deduce directly from the previous section where we have studied the total magnetic force on a random shaped wire. If there is a random shaped wire, it experiences a magnetic force BIL where L is the straight line length between the two edges of the wire. Thus, we have studied that in a magnetic induction, B vector, if we place a random shaped wire carrying a current I, then it will experience a force which is equivalent to the force which will act if a straight wire is placed between the ends A and B. If it is L, force experienced by this wire will be, the magnetic force will be BIL. As current is flowing from A to B, the magnetic force will be acting on it in this direction. Now, if A and B are joined and the wire is made as a closed loop, here L becomes 0 and we can directly write, always the force will be 0 if L is 0 or the wire is taking the shape of a closed loop. So, you can always keep this note in your mind that total magnetic force on a current carrying closed loop in uniform magnetic field is always equal to zero. But here we can see one more thing. In this situation, as the wire VC is experiencing a force in outward direction and the wire DA is experiencing a force in inward direction, which we have written here. As the force magnitude is same, total force is zero, but here we can see that the line of forces are not in same line. So these two forces will produce a couple and the coil will experience a torque. So we can write that total magnetic force on a current carrying closed loop in uniform magnetic field is always equal to zero, but it may experience a torque by magnetic force. I've written it mere experience because it is not necessary that always the line of action of two forces are different. If in some situation the line of action of the two opposite forces are same, then torque may also be equal to zero. About magnetic torque, we'll discuss in the next section in detail.